Hidden at the bottom of a section of Lake Tahoe is a strange group of rocks which have a dark secret. There, scattered at sections more than 1,000 feet deep, massive chunks of what was originally a hillside, some of which are more than a mile across, lay on the lake floor. Adding to this, large out-of-place boulders of rock can be found up to 34 miles downstream in the Truckee River. And, looking at topographic maps, there appears to be a figurative bight several miles wide carved into a section of McKinney Bay. What caused all of these aforementioned features was a truly devastating cataclysm which we were quite lucky occurred when humans did not live on Lake Tahoe's edge in large numbers, as this bight out of the McKinney Bay represents the very location where a section of ground comprising 3 cubic miles or 12.5 cubic kilometers of rock collapsed all at once in a massive landslide, as large blocks of material raced into the existing lake water at speeds of more than 100 miles per hour, the rock displaced significant sections of water, pushing the freshwater upwards. This created a towering megatsunami which had an initial wave height of 100 meters or 330 feet. Over the next 4 to 8 minutes, the first largest wave struck sections of Lake Tahoe's coastline, almost uniformly inundating everything 150 feet or less above the existing waterline. Southern Lake Tahoe was hardest hit, as although the wave heights there were less than at the initial landslide site, the fairly flat topography allowed the tsunami to reach more than 6 miles inland. However, once the first wave retreated, it caused all of the lake water to be pulled in the opposite direction, creating what is known as a seiche. Over the next 90 minutes, waves greater than 10 meters or 33 feet in height repeatedly sloshed back and forth, almost like in a bathtub. By the time the water completely subsided back to normal levels, what remained was a far-reaching and lifeless brown layer on the shoreline filled with toppled trees, somewhat similar to these two photos showing the aftermath of Alaska's 1958 Latoya Bay megatsunami, which was initially 1,700 feet in height. And what was previously a small bay was now enlarged by 300%, while landslide blocks generated by the event were now spread across an area of 90 square miles within Lake Tahoe. This landslide, which is referred to as the McKinney Bay landslide, occurred approximately 16,500 years ago. But there is a catch. We do not know if it occurred on that year or in a time frame plus or minus 4,500 years from that date, meaning this destructive event occurred sometime between 21,000 and 12,000 years ago. So, why did such a large-scale landslide occur? The answer is due to California's most significant geologic hazard, earthquakes. California has numerous lengthy fault lines, some of which have the potential to produce magnitude 6, 7, or even 8 earthquakes. While landslides can occur without being caused by an earthquake, the sheer size of this ancient event suggests it was triggered by an earthquake. While only a magnitude 4 quake or larger is needed to be capable of destabilizing already highly unstable slopes, generally speaking, a magnitude 6 or larger quake is needed to potentially generate some landslides on slopes that were not necessarily already highly unstable. The very area the landslide occurred is bordered to the east by a 25-kilometer long fault line, where the southern half of it is known to have moved during the Holocene Epoch, aka last 11,650 years, being known as the West Tahoe Fault. I thus theorized that a magnitude 6.5 to 7.2 earthquake struck along this fault 16,500 years ago and caused extreme shaking on nearby hillsides, triggering the large-scale landslide and megatsunami. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.